Next slide. Cannot move. Ah. Hello, my name is Richard Supriyatna ya. I'm here because I love to give presentation. This is my IG ya, yeah. Alban Tani.
IG ya, Pak?
IG ya, yeah.
Instagram.
Ya. Yeah. Transition headline. Okay. Ah, it is. For the first presentation, for the first my slide, yes, about the history, yeah. Let's see now, history, what the meaning of history? This is from the maybe Latin language, yeah. We know Historia Magistra Vitae, yeah. This is the jargon, maybe, yeah. Who's the learn the history? Mas familiar, this jargon ya, Historia Magistra Vitae, ya. Maksudnya adalah sejarah adalah guru yang terbaik. History is the best teacher, ya. Sejarah adalah sebuah pengalaman, ya. History has many many experience, ya. Sebuah pengalaman yang akan menjadikan kita orang yang bijaksana dan pintar ya. Jadi history we can learn from our experience last time ya. And become our attitude, our behavior, wisdom ya. And smart ya, smart people. Why smart people? Because we can learn from the past even, yeah, and not be repeated the wrong action from our attitude, yeah. Jadi kenapa kita disebut pintar? Karena supaya tidak mengulangi kesalahan-kesalahan kita di masa lalu, gitu ya. Jadi sejarah itu guru yang terbaik, ya, melalui pengalaman-pengalaman yang kita lalui di masa lalu. Dan juga pengalaman atau kejadian-kejadian ya, peristiwa-peristiwa masa lalu ya, sehingga membuat seseorang itu menjadi bijaksana dan juga menjadi orang yang pintar. Pintar di sini tidak mengulangi kesalahan yang terjadi di masa lalu. Karena hanya keledai ya, hanya keledai yang mengulangi kesalahan yang sudah pernah dilakukan. Keledai itu kan masuk kepada lubang yang sama, katanya kan udah pernah terjerumus di sebelah sana, eh ada lubang menginjak lagi di situ gitu. Nah, kita I hope you we are as the human being maybe not as apa keledai itu Pak Bupati ya. Tidak seperti keledai gitu ya. Oke, itu ya. Ini mudah-mudahan menjadi apa semacam ingatan dan pelajaran bagi kita. Oke, next slide. This is the definition of history. According to the etymology, and then the sejarah, this come from Arabic language, ya. Sajaratun. Like a tree, ya. This was tree. Mr. Miss Bidah, tree, pohon ya. Oke, pohon itu mengalami proses ya, pertumbuhan, develop, grow ya, to be continue ya, from small until big, from apa namanya short until long ya, dan dia memiliki akar, cabang dan buah. Muhammad Yamin, according to Muhammad Yamin opinion, history is there is the meaning from the history is growth or develop or even. Jadi Muhammad Yamin berpendapat sejarah itu tersimpan makna the meaning of growth and event, ya. Jadi pertumbuhan atau kejadian. And then the history is what is continuity and change. Jadi hakikat sejarah itu adalah perubahan, ya. Change, ya. Hakikat sejarah itu adalah perubahan, ya. Jadi perubahan dari mana? Dari waktu yang lalu, past event, until now maybe, ya, and the future, past, present, and the future. According to Sukarno, there is the three definition of history, ya, past, present, and the future. Past is maybe we can took the what is the remembering, ya, yeah, past event, the and masa lalu itu jadi kenangan, ya, yeah, dan masa sekarang itu menjadi tantangan, challenge, ya, yeah. Present is challenge and the future is harapan, ya, yeah. What is harapan, Bu Dida?
Hope.
Hope, ya, hope. Oke, okay, ya. Masa lalu itu jadi kenangan, masa sekarang jadi tantangan, masa depan itu jadi tantangan, ya. Our hope. Maybe. According to the Edward Hallett-Carr, history is the continuous process of interaction between the historian and his facts, and an ending dialogue between the present and the past. Is according to the Edward Hallett-Carr, history is the continuous process, and then never ending history, yeah, yeah, of the interaction, and in history is there is interaction between historian, yeah, and his fact, yeah, fakta-fakta, and ending dialogue, yeah, the fact must be analysis, must be collected, must be explained, ya, dialogue between the present and the past. Jadi menurut Carr, sejarah itu proses yang terus berkelanjutan dan dialog antara seorang sejarawan dengan fakta yang dia temukan, ya. Dan itu terus akan terjadi, ya, antara peristiwa-peristiwa yang terjadi masa kini dan juga peristiwa-peristiwa yang akan datang. Fakta, the fact cannot be speaking, ya, tidak akan banyak bisa bicara fakta itu kalau tidak dibunyikan, ya, kalau tidak dijelaskan, kalau tidak dideskripsikan, kalau tidak ditulis oleh seorang sejarawan. Kita bisa tahu misalnya when the independent day of America, maybe from Colombia, can tell me please when the independent day of United States of America, huh?
She hasn't coming yet.
Okay, coming yet. The Independence Day of America, the 17, ya, yeah, 76, yeah, 1776, itu kemerdekaan Amerika. From British, ya. Yeah. Amerika itu merdeka 1776 dari Inggris Raya, ya, British. Okay, will be continue according to definition or opinion from James Bank. Past event is history. History is actually. Jadi semua peristiwa yang terjadi masa lalu, ya, yang benar-benar terjadi itu sejarah. Hanya nanti akan terjadi perdebatan yang bagaimana yang jadi sejarah itu. apakah semua peristiwa masa lalu itu sejarah? Nah, itu nanti ada perdebatan di kalangan sejarawan. History can help students to understand human behavior in the past, present, and the future. Yeah, new goal for historical studies. Ini according to Samsudin ya, Eli Samsudin, one professor in the UPI, Department of History. Oh. And then, the past event is history. History as actually, jadi yang benar-benar terjadi ya. History can help students to understand human behavior. And then, if we learn the history science or history education, can help students to understand human behavior in the past, such as the ancient of Mesir, the ancient of Sumeria, Akkadia, Mesopotamia, the history, the ancient of the Mohenjo-Daro Harappa in India, such as the ancient history in China, and etc. Yeah. Mesopotamia, the fertile that we know, the fertile Christian, ya, daerah bulan sabit ya. There is the Nile of Euphrates and Tigris ya. Euphrates and Tigris, and in Mesir there is the Nile ya. Sungai Nile ya. That is the ancient civilization maybe, or the ancient history. Okay. Still definition of history, according to Abraham, his opinion, sejarah adalah suatu sains mengenai perkembangan manusia. History is about the science, the developing or growing the humanity. Yeah. And R.G. Collingwood said the research of history about the the action of human being in the past. Yeah. The attitude or behavior of human being in the past. Marx Bloch, history is activity of a human being in the past. And then if we see the definition of history, it is referred that history as the actually behavior, attitude, action, or the event who producted from the humanity as the history. History is the science, describe and studying about the community, and all aspect temporally. And Robin James Harvey Robinson opinion, history is all about the who has knowledge with the human being, of this attitude, behavior, thinking, and what is the sense, sense with the human being, apa yang dipikirkan, apa yang dilakukan, dan apa yang dirasakan. Di sejarah itu sangat luas ya, apa yang diketahui, apa semua yang diketahui tentang setiap hal yang pernah dilakukan oleh dilakukan dipikirkan atau dirasakan. Next slide we will be continue about the artifact from the history. Jadi hal-hal yang bisa ditinggalkan dari sejarah itu ada yang dalam bentuknya benda, ada yang dalam bentuknya hasil pikiran, dan juga hasil perasaan manusia. Maybe it is refer to the culture ya. Culture, you know, culture, budaya. Budaya juga itu hasil cipta karsa dan karya manusia. Ya. If we refer to the Kuncaraningrat definition or theory, culture is the apa yang dipikirkan, dirasakan, dan dikaryakan hasil karya dari manusia itu sendiri. The concept of history. History is not static studying, ya. Yeah. It is the dynamic studying, ya. Yeah. If we refer to Topolsky, there is the three basic definition of history. Firstly, the first past event or res gestae. Jadi sejarah itu sebagai peristiwa-peristiwa masa lalu. Secondly, the history as the research action from the historian. And the first history as the past event. Secondly, history as the product from research from historian. Yeah. And the third, history is the what is product from the research from historian. It is similar, yeah, from the second and the third. For the example, the explanation about the past event, a narrative about the past event. Narrative from the past event, such as the historiography, it is can be used in the school program. History in the primary school, yeah, di sekolah dasar, it is the lesson infusing in the social studies, not separated, but it is integrated. Integrated study with geography, history, economy, civic education, sociology, anthropology, and I don't know, maybe in the broad, such as in America, in Colombia, in Filipina, maybe different, yeah. But if I look in the national curriculum of social studies in the United States, history is integrated study be applicable, yeah, in primary school program and as the social studies. Jadi masuk ke dalam IPS as the integrated study. And as the transnistic education, ya, yeah, such as the civic education. Jadi itu menjadi pembelajaran IPS yang tematik, ya, yeah, terpadu sejarah itu di dalam IPS. Oke, okay, to be continue. In Indonesia, history in his all historiography. There is the two, yeah, new historiography. There is and the other. There is the old historiography, historiography lama, traditional historiography Nusantara, ya. Yeah. Belum, ya. Yeah. Before Indonesia, maybe independent, ya, yeah, from the Holland, ya. Yeah. We famous and we familiar with the what is beberapa, ya, yeah, beberapa konsep or istilah, ya, yeah, from the history. such as babat, serat, sejarah, cerita, wawacan, hikayat, tutur, silsilah, riwayat, tarikh, tambo, dan kidung. This according to Sujat Moko ya, in Helly Samsudin 2007. Yeah. 2007. Jadi di dalam historiografi tradisional, sejarah itu memiliki makna atau konsep atau istilah ya, istilah yang berbeda-beda. Seperti babat, babat tanah Jawa, babat Banten, babat Cirebon, serat, serat Wirid Hidayat Jati. Itu menerangkan tentang kerajaan kesultanan Cirebon ya. Ada juga yang menyebut sejarah, ada cerita, cerita Purwaka Carubanagari. Itu juga bicara tentang kerajaan, apa kesultanan Banten misalnya, kesultanan Cirebon ya. Wawacan. Nah, ini wawacan Syekh tentang babat-babat, menceritakan tentang Kesultanan Banten itu ada wawacan Syekh Rifai misalnya. Nah, kemudian hikayat, ya, ada juga hikayat ya. Nah, jadi ini lebih banyak kepada tutur biasanya ya, kepada cerita turun temurun tutur ini sejak oral history, silsilah ya, genealogi ya, bisa juga kemudian riwayat, tarikh, tarikh this refer to Islamic concept ya, in Islam concept is tarikh, tambo, kidung. Ini biasanya tambo, kidung ini dengan nada-nada tertentu ya, itu ada di yang menceritakan kerajaan Majapahit, kerajaan Pajang ya. Oke, okay, we are to the next slide. About the methodology of history. In history, there is the methodology. History as science. Ya. Jadi, walaupun ada juga yang meragukan sejarah itu ilmu apa bukan. Ya, saya yang pernah mempelajari sejarah menyatakan ya di sini sejarah itu adalah sebuah ilmu. Jadi karena masih banyak itu mengadongeng sebenarnya. Mengadongeng gitu. Padahal kalau memang sejarah itu ilmu yang tertua, ingat, ilmu yang tertua di dunia ini sebetulnya sejarah. Sebelum ada ilmu-ilmu yang lain. Dan sejarawan yang pertama itu Herodotus. Herodotus yang menjelaskan tentang Pulau Kreta ya, kerajaan Romawi, tentang kerajaan apa Romawi kuno gitu ya, itu Herodotus ya. Itu 3000 sebelum Masehi ya. Bayangkan tuh. Baru nanti kesini-sininya ada filsafat. Jadi kalau nggak mungkin ada ilmu-ilmu lain kalau nggak ada orang tuanya kan. Jadi yang melahirkan ilmu-ilmu kesini itu adalah sejarah. Bagaimana mungkin ada anak ilmu kalau nggak ada orang tuanya? Betul nggak, Bu Dida? Pak Hanif? Ya. Jadi ilmu yang pertama itu awal-awal Herodotus, sejarawan pertama itu ya. Bisa dicek oleh rekan-rekan. Jadi there is the fourth step in methodology history, historical methodology. Ya, yeah. There is the fourth step. Ya, yeah. Fourth what is? Ya, langkah gitu ya.
Fourth step.
Step. Ya, yeah, yeah. Step. Langkah.
Four step to study history ya Pak.
Ya, yeah, four step to study history. The first step is heuristic. You know heuristic? Heuristic no. Is looking and discovering about the fact in the past event. Mencari the fact and the data. You know? I think every research, every yes, research must be looking for the data, ya.
Finding the fact, ya Pak.
Pasti memerlukan data, mencari data. Nggak mungkin ada penelitian, ya, itu tidak ada datanya. Nggak mungkin, itu bukan penelitian kalau sebuah riset tidak ada datanya. Mana datanya? Nggak ada, nggak punya. Bukan riset itu, ya. Jadi, the first step is heuristic. Heuristic looking for the data or the fakta in the past event. Jadi, heuristic itu adalah mencari data-data. Such as the oral, maybe oral history, ya, sejarah lisan, bisa the hard fact, bisa the soft fact, ya. Jadi fakta keras, such as prasasti, fosil, ya, dokumen, ya, sertifikat, misalnya, ya, dokumen-dokumen tertulis, piagam, itu fakta keras. Bisa juga yang soft fact, ya, tadi yang dituturkan, ya, dari orang-orang misalnya yang menyaksikan peristiwa tersebut melalui apa, interviewing the respondent, ya, the historian, the apa namanya, narasumber, ya. And the second step is the critic. Nah, setelah kita menemukan fakta-fakta, data-data, nah, data-data itu kita kritik. Jadi tidak dipercaya begitu saja. Misalnya sekarang apa itu yang kontroversi Super Semar, ya. Super Semar itu ada tiga versi. Ada yang disimpan di Arsip Nasional, ada katanya di Setnek, ya, ada yang katanya dipegang oleh Jenderal M. Yusuf almarhum, ya. Jadi mana yang asli, ya, sampai sekarang, ya, kalau versi negara yang sekarang ada di Arsip Nasional itu, nah, itu dikritik, benar enggak nih kertasnya. Misalnya ada dokumen tentang dibubarkannya Kesultanan Banten, ya, oleh siapa, Herman William Dender itu, Gubernur Jenderal Belanda itu, ya, 1882 atau 1886 gitu, ya. Jadi Kepresidenan Banten menjadi Kabupaten Serang, ya. Itu memang dibubarkan gitu, ya. Dan bupati diturunkan dari jadi kesultanan itu menjadi diturunkan menjadi pangkatnya itu hanya sebagai seorang bupati, Bupati Serang gitu. Itu 1884 misalnya, 1886. Tapi setelah dilihat dokumennya kok kayak baru gitu. Ini mah kertasnya juga kertas tahun 2000 gitu, ya. Nah, itu diragukan, enggak mungkin kertasnya masih bersih, kertasnya masih kayak baru, terus tulisannya juga kayak masih basah gitu, ya. Itu dikritik, jadi tidak langsung serta merta ada dokumen itu dipercaya gitu, ya. Jadi, nah, kritik juga ada dua, internal kritik and external kritik, ya. Jadi kalau internal itu menyangkut kepada fisik bendanya, kalau eksternal itu menyangkut internal itu menyangkut kontennya, isinya. Kalau
internal for the content.
Ya, internal for the content, and external itu for the apa? Misalnya kertasnya gitu, kertasnya. Jadi fisiknya gitu.
Ya, yeah, for the physical.
For the physical, okay. For the physical, ya. Yeah.
Physical finding, ya, Pak.
Physical finding, okay. Ya, yeah. Internal for the content, ya, yeah. And external is this for the physical content, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the third step is interpretation. Interpretation, yeah. After we critique the data and the what is the fakta, and the third is the interpretation. Kita interpretasi, kita tafsirkan. Oh, iya, betul, ini pernah Sultan Banten itu mengirim misalnya duta besar Denmark dan ke apa namanya Inggris ya pada abad ke-17 misalnya dengan mengirimkan pangeran siapa itu Nala Praya dengan siapa gitu ya. Ini ada stempelnya, ini ada suratnya, oh ini benar ditafsirkan. Nah, after we interpretation, it is explanation. Dijelaskan. Nah, explanation and expose. Ya, dituliskan dalam bentuk tulisan. Jadilah dokumen, jadilah buku sejarah. Gitu ya. The three activity from historian is what is refer to historiography ya. Jadi tiga aktivitas yang dilakukan oleh seorang sejarawan itu masuk ke dalam kegiatan historiography. Jadi penulisan sejarah. Historiography is refer to writing the history. Writing the history. Historiography is writing the history. The three activity include in historiography is interpretation, explanation, and expose. Jadi selesai. Kalau sebuah peristiwa sejarah itu sudah dituliskan oleh seorang sejarawan, maka selesai sebuah activity dari seorang sejarawan. Tinggal nanti oleh pembaca itu di apakah dikritisi lagi silahkan itu. Kalau punya data baru mau membantah silahkan. Nah, it is the methodology of sejarah ya of history. There is the heuristic, kritik internal and external. Internal from of the content, external from the maybe this is the data, the document, and historiography is three activity, interpretation, explanation, and input. Okay, let's be continue to the object of history. There is the two object of history. Yeah. For the first is the artifact, the fact, the hard fact. Yeah. Jadi fakta keras. Bupati ya, artefak itu peninggalan masa lalu yang bersifat benda, ya artefak bisa dilihat, dipegang, dilihat, ya such as prasasti, ya such as batu, ya dokumen, kertas ataupun misalnya apa bendera, apa tombak, apa cap ataupun mahkota raja, baju raja misalnya ya. Pokoknya yang bersifat benda yang terjadi di masa lalu dan ada bedil misalnya atau apapun ya. Huruf, uang, mata uang, gerabah, guci misalnya itu artefak. Nah, untuk khusus untuk tulang belulang baik itu manusia maupun binatang itu disebutnya itu fosil. Ya, artefak juga, cuman kalau bentuknya tulang belulang itu fosil ya. Do you know fosil? I think in English maybe fosil ya.
Ya, yeah, fosil.
Fosil ya, fosil. Oke, okay? Fosil ya. That as Pithecanthropus erectus, insangiran ya. Pithecanthropus paleojapanicus in Solo, what is? River, Solo, oke, okay. Ya, Homo sapiens, nah, peninggalan dari manusia-manusia purba itu disebutnya fosil. Bisa juga fosil binatang, misalnya fosil dinosaurus, misalnya fosil apa yang ada di Museum Geologi di Bandung itu kan fosil gajah purba, ya, nah, itu masuknya fosil itu ya. Nah, yang kedua, the second is the object of the history is writing document such as prasasti, naskah, bo, atau peninggalan tertulis lainnya, ya, yang merupakan bahan rekaman peristiwa tersebut, ya. Tadi dokumen Super Semar, dokumen, do you know, because Indonesia in the near time we are what is memorizing the Independence Day, yeah, of Indonesia 17 Agustus, yeah, last week, the last time, itu kan ada teks proklamasi kemerdekaan. Nah itu dokumen sejarah. Itu kan disimpan di arsip, ya, ada coret-coretan Bung Karno, Bung Hatta, ya. Nah itu luar biasa diperlakukannya aja tersendiri, ya. Kenapa? Karena sudah rap. Ya, kalau sembarangan itu bisa sobek, ya. Nah, makanya diperlakukannya khusus. Pak Lembabannya
Hanif,
itu.
Nanti tolong presentasi ulang ya dari layar Pak Hanif. Presentasi ulang file PowerPoint-nya Pancak.
Kenapa? Bupati? Why?
Oh, yeah, sorry, Pak. Because some participant didn't understand bahasa Indonesia.
Okay.
Yes, would you like to speak in English more?
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay.
Yeah, but yes. I will resume at the end of Mr. Encep's presentation. Maybe Pancep, okay. Would you like to when you have finished your explanation, I will give the English version of
yes.
your explanation.
Yes, little again. This is the picture of word, the thousand word, yeah. Maybe from the world, from abroad, you can see the picture of the sultanate, the village, yeah.
Village.
Istana itu village. Of Surasawan village, yeah.
The picture is in Banten, ya, Pak?
Yes, Kroto, village Surasawan, Banten. Okay. It's the gate. Is the what is the bedroom, yeah, and it is the what is apa battle, yeah, the battle, yeah, ini the apa namanya, battle, yes,
benteng,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, the next slide, this is the all Banten area in Kasemen, ya. Yeah. This is the tower of the Banten Lama, ya. Yeah. Tower, and this is the most of the great most Banten, ya. Yeah. Bukit Agung, the great most Banten, ya. Yeah. This is the tower. The in past. In last time, the tower is news for observation the what is enemy, yeah, who come from the abroad, such as Holland, British, yeah. This is viewing, seeing, looking from here, yeah. Because this is near from the Karangantu seaside, ya. The Banten Lama, the old Banten, it is near from the seaside of Karangantu seaside. Okay.
The Karangantu Fort.
Oh, Karangantu Fort, yeah. Maybe for last time in the past. Karangantu Port, ya, pelabuhan, ya, yeah, pelabuhan, ya. Yeah. But yes, until now, ya, yeah, news from as the port, but maybe for the fishermen, ya, yeah, para nelayan, not for ekspor impor barang, gitu ya. This is the ilmu bantu sejarah. This is the auxiliary science. Ya, auxiliary science, archaeology, philology, philology, yeah, the science you... of mm-hmm. Yes.
When you study the history, you can use these tools to study history.
Yes. Yeah. If we study in history department, we can use the tool or the auxiliary ilmu bantu, ya, auxiliary science, yeah, for help. History. Yeah, to help the concept and theory, ya, yeah, in historiography. Ya, di dalam proses mm-hmm. penyusunan itu, we can use this science. Ya, yes. That's as the philology. Yeah, philology, the science refer to language and mm-hmm. arts, ya. Yeah? And linguistic maybe, ya. Yeah? mm-hmm. Ya. Yeah.
Language, jadi, Pak, language.
Language, ya, yeah? Philology. Yeah. And paleography. Paleography, it is tulisan kuno. That's as the... Palawa, ya, Sangsekerta, ya, nah, Pegon, nah, ilmu piaga,
paleografi,
paleografi, ya, ya, hmm. ilmu piaga, kronologi, urutan waktu,
timeline,
timeline, numismatik, hmm. numismatik,
money mata currency, uang kuno.
Hah? Numismatik,
at the past. Money,
yes.
currency at the past.
Money, currency at the past. And anthropology.
And anthropology.
Yeah. Anthropology, it is the science about the asal-usul manusia, ya. Yeah?
Hmm.
What is in English? The race and tribal of the human being, maybe, ya. Yeah? Ah, okay.
The origin.
The origin species of human being, ya. Yeah. It is the table of historical motion. Motion, it is in history we can study the motion of history. Penggerak sejarah, you know, motion of history, the motion of mm-hmm. history. Jadi sejarah itu ada yang menggerakkan. Jadi dia tidak terjadi dengan sendirinya, ada yang menggerakkan.
Yeah. Nah, dari sejarah must have motif, ya, Pak.
Yes, yes. Oke, okay. motion or what is gerak, ya?
Yeah. When we want the history study to move, so
yes.
you need some motif that
motif,
move yeah. the okay. historical okay. Historical science, like yeah. yeah, like God and then
man
yeah,
and
the nature.
There is the three mazhab, the three what is
mainstream.
The three yes, mainstream. The three mainstream of the historical motion.
Historical.
The first is. The first is the historical motion, moving, digerakkan ya, digerakkan itu apa?
Yeah, move by.
Move by God.
God.
Yeah. God, yeah. It is referred to monotheism and polytheism, yeah. And maybe in Islam religion is kodo dan kodar, ya, takdir. Jadi kejadian itu sudah takdirnya, gitu ya. Ada dipercaya oleh banyak orang, many human being, ya, they are believe that the history can be moved, can be motioned with the gods. Then the man just apa menerima aja begitu apa adanya, ya, apa itu bahasa Inggris?
Pasif.
Ah, pasif, yeah. Man is pasif, ya, yeah. Pasif. Menerima receipt what the God willing, ya, yeah. Okay?
Mm.
Yeah, apa yang Tuhan inginkan gitu terhadap seseorang itu terima saja, ya. Yeah.
Yeah.
And the second is man, ya, yeah, refer to the great man theory. This is the mazhab, the mainstream come from the Annales school in Francis. Jadi teori orang besar itu yang mencetuskan dari mazhab Annales school di Prancis bahwa penggerak sejarah itu manusia besar. Maybe in Indonesia saat Soekarno, Hatta, ya. In Colombia maybe I don't know ya. In Filipina maybe siapa? Fidel Ramos. Siapa yang tokoh pergerakannya itu?
Aquino.
Aquino. Ya, Aquino ya. Thomas Aquino ya. Kemudian siapa lagi? Nah, to the hero ya, refer to the hero ya. I think in every country there is the hero. Ya. Maybe not only country but also in the apa daerah district there is the hero ya. Yeah. As in Banten there is the three hero ya. Yeah. Hero nation hero such as the Mr. Safrudin Prawira Negara, Sultan Agung Tirtayasa, Sultan Ageng Tirtayasa and the last Brigjen K. Haji Sampun, ya. Brigjen K. Haji Sampun, ya. But in nasional, there's many hero, ya. In abroad tadi, ya, yeah, in Filipina, maybe Aquino, Pedro Ramos. Ada itu tokoh pergerakan nasional dari Filipina itu. Saya lupa lagi, ya. I forgot, ya.
Magsasay, maybe. Raymond Magsasay maybe?
Hah?
Raymond Magsasay?
It is what is he like in the sometime with the gerakan San Min Chu Ai in the Tiongkok. Siapa itu yang tokoh pergerakan Tiongkok itu ya? Josh siapa itu? Josh Rizal. Ah, Josh Rizal itu ya. Josh Rizal, oke, okay, I remember itu Josh Rizal, ya. Kalau yang di Tiongkok tuh revolusi Tiongkok itu yang San Min Chua itu siapa itu?
Jose Rizal.
Rizal ya itu di Filipina. Yang di Tiongkoknya ada tokoh revolusinya itu ya. Nah ini nanti akan gerakan halayak community ya, yeah, they influence the community in Iran maybe such as the Ali Khamenei ya, yeah. Iran Ali Khamenei ya, yeah. Indonesia Soekarno in Hatta, Sahrir, Agus Salim ya, yeah. Siapa lagi, Iwak Suma Sumantri ya, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Tokro Aminoto.
Tokro Aminoto, ya. This is the they are the great men, ya. Orang-orang yang berjiwa besar. Jadi the hero, ya. Tokoh,
the
ya.
The individual yes. Who move the history, yeah. Ya, Pak.
Yes, okay. And the third is the natural. Nah, natural. Ya. The motion of history is by natural, yeah. Moved by nature, such as the animism and dynamism belief in primitive culture, yeah. Mm-hmm. Community, society, yeah. Such as the apa ini? Gunung meletus. What is? Hal in English? Wabah, banjir besar, what is, apa?
Flood,
eruption.
Yeah. Eruption, monstein, eruption, ya. Yeah.
Tsunami,
ya. Yeah.
COVID, maybe.
Pandemi, ya. Yeah. Jadi adanya penyakit,
ya.
Yeah. Yeah. Penyakit itu. Ya, seperti apa kerajaan-kerajaan di Jawa itu kayak Mataram, ya konon katanya salah satunya Mataram kuno ya, bukan Mataram Islam itu karena ada wabah. Ya, ada wabah. Nah, jadi itu menyebabkan apa namanya? Peristiwa sejarah yang besar. Let us know, we are in pandemic COVID-19. Ah, present. Now we are in pandemic era COVID-19. Maybe in the
future,
this became the history.
Yeah? The history moment.
Yeah, history moment for our son, our
granddaughter.
Ini akan jadi sejarah bagi anak cucu kita ini ya. Bahwa di tahun 2000-2001 terjadi pandemi COVID-19 yang mengakibatkan sekian ribu, di Indonesia sekian, bukan ribu, ratus kayaknya ya. Ratus ribu. Kalau di dunia mungkin jutaan. Ya,
million. Million people died. Just because the COVID outbreak.
Ya, COVID, ya. Nah, itu. Ini kan tidak ada, ya, belum tahu kita. Tapi ini pandemi kan, alami gitu. Artinya terjadi ada virus, yang tiba-tiba virus ada itu kemudian mewabah seluruh penjuru dunia, sehingga kita menjadi korban, terpapar.
Yeah.
Nah, this is the historical motion.
The by historical nature. Motion. Yeah. One of the historical motion, ya Pak.
One of the historical motion by nature.
Not from the nature aspect.
Yeah, not from God, maybe not from
human. But doing by nature. Okay.
It is the for the actually maybe example ya. The historical motion by nature, such as the pandemic COVID-19. Okay. Let me look the map of Banten, all Banten in 16th century. 16th century, yeah, 1596. This is the river Banten. This is the, what is? Ship. It is true, ship, perahu, yeah.
Boat.
This is the village. The apa keraton Surasawan. This is the small river. The Sultan of Banten is the aquatic city, you know, because the city of Banten, all Banten is dikelilingi itu apa ya, you know, dikelilingi oleh sungai-sungai kecil yang bisa dilalui oleh perahu-perahu yang
berukuran kecil.
Rounded with the small river ya. Sini. Jadi di sekeliling bentengnya itu ada sungai-sungai yang bisa dilalui oleh jukung-jukung kecil ya. Nah, ini di sini ya. Ini kapal-kapal yang come from abroad ya. Such as from Holland, British, Persia, from Arab, from China, ya, yeah. This come to Banten Port, ya, yeah. Banten Port, they are must be what is towing the maybe now as passport, but last time maybe called with the apa namanya surat gitu ya, surat masuk ya, nanti mereka itu dicap, bayar pajak ya. Nah, itu ada jembatan rantainya, itu ada jembatan seperti di Ampera. Nanti kalau sudah bayar pajak, bea cukai, you know, bea cukai, I don't know what called in English, bea cukai ya. Cukai
pajak,
pajak. Tax. Ya, after they are pay the tax, they are can entering the Fort Banten and trading, berdagang ya, trading, many many commodity from country. Ya. Jadi start as textile, honey, apa itu? Gerabah ya, Gucci ya. Textile from India, Gucci from China ya. Kayu gaharu ya, itu dari biasanya itu dari Timur Tengah ya. Nah, itu and they are buying the commodity from Indonesia, from Nusantara. This commodity that as tembakau, what is called in English? Cengkeh, lada.
For trading.
Ya, yeah, for trading.
Rempah.
Rempah-rempah ya. Rempah-rempah from Banten, from Nusantara. Yes. Yeah. For selling in their country, ya. Yeah. That we know in the 16th century, the Portuguese and Spanish, there is the what is Portuguese and Spanish bermusuhan tuh apa? Enemy ya. And with Paulus didamaikan, kemudian mereka disuruh menjelajah samudra ya. Itu Portugis ke timur, Spanyol ke barat. Nah, and they meet in Malacca in 1511. You know? Di tahun 1511 mereka bertemu di Malacca, Malacca Strait, you know? In Malacca Strait near from the Sumatra. Ya. Yeah? Malacca Strait, there is the Malaysia Malacca is okay, in 1511. Ya. Yeah. Portuguese arrive in Malacca. And menyusul ya, Spanyol datang juga. Kenapa di sini? Kamu kan ke timur, ke barat, saya ke timur. Kenapa kamu ke sini juga? Ya, kamu kenapa kok ke sini? Saya kan beda arah nih. Akhirnya terjadi pertengkaran lagi ya di Nusantara. Akhirnya berdamai, ada namanya Perjanjian Saragosa. Nah, tapi perjanjian yang pertama itu yang di Lisbon, di Spanyol, di Lisboa, ititu namanya Perjanjian Tordesillas, didamaikan oleh Paus supaya tidak berebutan jajahan begitu ya. Ketemu juga. Nah, di sini akhirnya terbukti bahwa dunia itu bulat. Tidak yang ngampar, tidak datang. Walaupun berbeda jalur ternyata bertemu. Akhirnya teori tentang bumi datar itu terbantahkan. Ya. Dan itu dikemukakan berapa abad yang lalu ya, dari Galileo itu kan. But in the holy doctrine in Injil ya, dalam Kitab Suci menyatakan yaitu datar gitu ya. Dan itu terbantahkan sehingga Galileo itu harus mati di tiang gantungan karena teorinya. Jadi perjanjiannya diperbarui, Perjanjian Saragosa. Akhirnya Spanyol menyingkir ke Filipina. There is the participant from Filipina. Yeah. Jadi Portugis menetap di Malacca, Spanyol ke Filipina, menjajah Filipina akhirnya. Gitu. Karena kalau dua-duanya di sini pasti berantem lagi.
So the Banten port is the place for Spain merchant and Portuguese merchant meet together. Is that right, Pancep?
Yes, like that.
Yeah, and okay. Portuguese go to Filipina and or Spain go to Filipina and Portuguese is here.
Yes. Is this true?
Is that true, Pancep?
Yes.
I try to translate your
it's true,
story.
True. Spanyol to Filipina.
Spanyol go to Filipina and Portuguese.
But Spanyol is be what is loser with the America. Spanyol nanti kalah juga karena Amerika datang. Nah, terakhir nanti yang menjajah Filipina itu Amerika. Spanyol menyingkir lagi, gitu ya, karena kalah dia. Ya. And in the 1987, the Cornelis de Houtman, Cornelis de Houtman, rape in the Port Banten. Nah, you know Cornelis de Houtman? Nah,
Cornelis de Houtman. Is it from Holland, Pak?
From Holland. Yes, from Holland.
Oh.
Come in Banten Port.
Arrive at Banten Port.
Yeah, arrive at Banten Port. Ya. 1597. Tadi 1511 Portugis.
15. Yes.
Ya, 1597, 1596.
1597. 97.
Itu datang di Teluk Banten. Ya. Ini 1596 nih.
Banten Port.
Iya, Banten Port. Nah, ini jadi satu tahun. Ini kan peta, jadi pas ini petanya ini. Satu tahun sebelum kedatangan Cornelis, ini petanya seperti ini. Ya. Hmm. Jadi di sini makanya peta awal kedatangan pelayaran Belanda.
Oh, this is the map when in Banten no colonize.
Yes, before colonize.
No colonization.
Yes, before colonized.
Before Banten being colonized.
Colonized with the Holland.
With the Holland.
And the Sultan of Banten is what is Homi and Kami please trading in our port. Jadi awalnya itu diterima dengan baik.
Yeah. For the first time, the merchant only doing trading. Not for colonizing.
Not,
But
after that, because the Holland is monopoly, you know monopoly, monopoly, monopoly perdagangan, monopoly trading, Nah, dari sini mulai muncul masalah. Jadi dia menguasai menentukan harga. Ini yang boleh dijual, ini yang boleh tidak. Mm-hmm. Kok datang kok ngatur gitu. Ya kan. Monopoli ya. Nah, dari sini mulai ada riak-riak ya. Monopoli ya, monopoli. Apalagi nanti pada tahun 1602
1602.
Belanda itu membuat apa yang disebut dengan VOC.
The Holland made VOC. What is VOC, Pak?
Vereniging Oost Indische Company. Kongsi Dagang Hindia Belanda.
What is in English, Pak Hanif?
Holding company.
Holding company. Jadi karena banyak pedagang yang lain kan, Inggris, apa namanya, dari Persia, dari Arab, dari Cina, dari India. Nah, mereka bersatu oleh Ratu Belanda itu supaya kalian mampu bersaing, bikin kongsi dagang. Supaya bisa melawan pedagang yang lain, kan? Supaya kuat modalnya ini itunya. Didirikanlah VOC. Ya. Vereniging Oost Indische Company itu 1602. Ya. Nah, VOC inilah yang mulai monopoli.
And then the VOC get monopoly. Ya.
Great monopoli. Dan VOC ini dia diberi hak istimewa oleh Ratu Belanda, ya, Ratu Wilhelmina. Itu pertama, boleh memiliki mata uang sendiri. They can make the what is? Mata uang?
Their currency.
Their own currency.
Okay. Okay, the first. The third can membuat memiliki balad tentara sendiri, punya pasukan sendiri.
Have troops.
Okay. The third mereka boleh mendirikan benteng pertahanan.
They can make fort,
forts, and the battle. Ya, kemudian mereka juga diberi hak istimewa yang keempat, melakukan perjanjian dagang. Ya, they dengan kerajaan. Oke, the old agreement. Ya, jadi seperti negara, perusahaan, tapi kekuasaannya itu seperti negara. Tadi boleh memiliki mata uang, boleh memiliki bala tentara sendiri, boleh mendirikan loji atau benteng, dan boleh melakukan perjanjian dagang. Ya, dengan dulu negara, belum ada Indonesia ya, kesultanan itu ya negara berdaulat dengan kerajaan-kerajaan yang ada gitu ya. Nah, bayangkan itu ya. Nah, dari sinilah dia karena merasa kuat melakukan monopoli. Ya, sehingga terjadilah peperangan-peperangan ya. Jadi kerajaan-kerajaan the Sultanate of Nusantara ya, the what is sultan or the kings in Nusantara is the what is not occupation ya. Because they are colonized and imperialist ya. Colonized itu menguasai, imperial itu memerintah. Setelah mengkoloni memerintah ya. Imperial itu kan memerintah. Ya, colonize itu menguasai, menduduki, occupation, ya. They are imperials the many kings kingdom ya in Nusantara, such as Banten, Cirebon, Mataram, Ternate, Tidore, yang in Makassar, Goa, Talo, ya. They are the many kingdom in Nusantara. There are attacks, attack ya. Apa itu attack? Itu memerangi, attacks ya. Attack the VOC ya, because they are monopoly trading in Nusantara. Attacked the VOC. Hampir satu abad. VOC itu umurnya hampir 100 tahun. Karena dia runtuh itu tahun 1797. Ya, kan berdirinya 1602. 1796 apa 97 lah ya. Hampir satu abad itu VOC itu.
VOC have their rule ya Pak ya in the Indonesia rule. In Indonesia trading especially in Banten from 1602 until 1797.
Okay.
Yeah, it almost 100 years.
One century. Ya, yeah. Abad itu century ya. One century. Okay. Jadi rekan-rekan, kalau ada yang menyatakan Indonesia dijajah 350 tahun, itu dari mana dulu? Ya, kalau saya mempertanyakan, kalau dari VOC ya 350, tapi yeah. Kalau dihitung dari karena setelah VOC runtuh, baru kemudian Belanda langsung yang menjajah. Artinya kita di bawah kerajaan Belanda. Kalau waktu VOC itu belum menguasai keseluruhan ini, kerajaan di Nusantara belum, jadi dia parsial. Jadi kalau dihitungnya dari 796 itu tidak nyampe 350 tahun. Kalau dihitungnya dari VOC bisa saja. Karena VOC waktu itu belum menguasai, kadang-kadang ini dikuasai kerajaan yang lain mah tidak.
No. Yeah. Just some other part of the Nusantara, not all okay. Of the Nusantara.
Not all the Nusantara, yeah. Just yes. Part of the Nusantara or part of the kingdom. As Banten, maybe occupation.
As Banten, yeah. In Banten, starting from 1602, ya, Pak.
Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, will be continue. This is the map of Banten now.
Yeah, today. Yeah.
Today.
This Banten is a province.
Yeah,
not a kingdom anymore.
Yes, is province, is modern government, not Sultanate again. And this is our campus in Serang City. Do you know here? Do you know?
At the green part.
Yes, the green part. Serang City, yeah. Yeah. Serang City. This is the Kabupaten Serang, yeah.
Serang District.
Serang District, yeah. This is the Fort of Banten here.
Fort of Banten is.
This is Sunda Shrine. Sunda Shrine. Mas Sunda. This is the Samudra Hindia.
Hindia Ocean.
Hindia Ocean, yeah. Samudra Hindia Ocean. Okay. This is the Bandegang District. This is the Cilegon City. This is the Tangerang, yeah. Okay. Can move? Cannot? Back, yeah. This is the Ujung Kulon, yeah. Ujung Kulon, here. Yeah. Pulau Panaitan, Pulau Pocang, yeah. Here.
Yeah. Pocang Island.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. The wonderful
wonderful place to visit.
Yes. Yeah. Sat as Tanjung Lesung here.
Yeah. Yeah. Tanjung Lesung.
This is the specialist autist destination. The big destination, maybe national destination priority, yeah. Tanjung Lesung. Yeah. Do you know, Mr. Roro, Tanjung Lesung, yeah. Please you visit here.
I don't
There is the what is we call badak bertulah satu? Hah? Binatang langka ya, hewan langka yang hampir punah.
Distinctive.
Rhinoceros.
Rhinoceros here, yeah.
Who have one
what standuk?
Horn.
Horn, yeah. One horn, yeah.
One horn.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Only one horn.
Yeah. Okay, the participant from abroad, Filipina, Colombia, please come to our country, especially to Banten, because our society very very interesting, very very wonderful. You can surfing, you can diving, you can snorkeling, yeah, here, yeah, and the biota of underwater is very very this
beautiful.
Okay. Nah, di sini ada kawasan khusus and in the near time will be finished the tall connected from the Serang City to the Panimbang, yeah. From Serang, yeah. From near from Serang, yeah. Before Kragilan, there is the entering, yeah. The start from Serang until Panimbang, just 2 hour, yeah. Hanya 2 jam nanti perjalanan di sini itu, yeah. Dari Serang ke sini ke Tanjung Lesung by tol, ya, pas tol, do you know tol? Maybe in broad same ya, tol ya, yeah, the lebih jalan
highway.
Okay, and then our campus here ya, yeah, UPI kampus Serang pro in Serang City. Nah, How about the demography in Sultanate Banten in the 17th century, 1672 ya, abad 17. There is the one, berarti 1500 itu 150,000 the demography of people from what is laki-laki ya, men,
children,
woman, children, yeah, and the lansia itu
and the oldest.
Yeah, the oldest. Katanya nih ya, menurut para sejarawan kayak GJ Lerisa from UI, untuk ukuran kota waktu itu kota termasuk kota besar Banten itu. Jadi megalopolitan. Yeah. Disamakan dengan London, bisa disamakan dengan Iran, bisa disamakan dengan kota-kota besar di dunia.
Ya. Yeah.
Ya, yeah, Paris
with the population.
Yeah, yes, with the population.
It is a big city.
Big population. Yeah, big city. Ya. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Ukuran waktu itu ya, jangan bicara sekarang. Ukuran
not today ya, Pak, for that time.
Yes, for the time. Then GJ Lerisa, historian from UI, Indonesia University, Banten in the 17th century it is as emporium and imperium. Do you know imperium? Imperium because he apa namanya membawahi itu ya, occupation the little kingdom in the near in Banten, such as the tulang bawang in Lampung. You know, kerajaan tulang bawang di Lampung itu dikuasai penghasil lada dan cengkeh, dikuasai oleh Banten. Dia juga menyerang ke kerajaan Sriwijaya di Palembang. Pernah juga melakukan serangan ke Mataram, ya. Sriwijaya itu pernah melakukan ini, ya, ke kerajaan Sriwijaya misalnya itu ya. Makanya Pangeran Muhammad itu meninggal itu di Palembang, Pangeran Sedaing Palembang, ya, karena meninggal dan di sungai apa itu Musi ya, Palembang itu sungai apa itu? Sungainya.
Iya, Musi.
Musi. Yang ada jembatan Ampera itu terjadi peperangan, jadi hampir menang. Ya. Nah, itu atas hasutan Pangeran Purbaya dari kerajaan Mataram ya, yang dia berambisi untuk menjadi sultan juga karena di sana itu disisihkan gitu. Maka dia ingin jadi panglima, ingin jadi patih dengan cara menghasut Pangeran Muhammad yang usianya waktu itu baru 9 apa 12 tahun gitu. Karena mengganti bapaknya ya, Pangeran Sultan Mulyana Yusuf yang meninggal. Jadi masih usia muda. Dan sehingga diwalikan kepada ibunya. Nah itu ya, jadi meninggal di sana. Jadi kalah, tidak berhasil, ya, dan meninggal. Oke, ini pembabakan waktu dalam sejarah. Sejarah itu in periodisasi ya. To be understand the history must be separated, like a sinetron, ya. Yeah. Episode, do you know episode or period, ya. Yeah. This refer to Indonesia, maybe geografis Kutai Kartanegara. Luar Jawa. Kronologis, kalau berdasarkan kronologi zaman kuno ya, dulu kuno itu misalnya zaman manusia purba, zaman pertengahan ya, zaman modern ini kalau di Eropa ini zaman kuno, pertengahan itu abad sampai 1500 itu abad pertengahan ya. Zaman baru itu ditemukannya mesin uap abad 15 16 17 18. Modern itu 1920-21 sampai sekarang. Di Cina misalnya ada dinasti Shang, Chou, Qin, Han, Sui. Nah, pembagian atas dasar agama ada sebelum Masehi dan setelah Masehi. Di Indonesia dan Asia Tenggara ini zaman Hindi, zaman penyiaran Islam, kerajaan Islam, zaman berdirinya kerajaan Islam, munculnya bangsa barat nih 1511 tadi mendaratnya Portugis ya di Malaka sampai 1800 yaitu sejarah VOC dan zaman orang Indonesia di lingkungan dia Belanda ini abad 1800.
Ya, yeah, this is the timeline of history around the world ya, Pak.
Yes, around the world.
Ya. Yeah.
Yeah. In China.
In China. In China there is what is that, Pak? The name.
Dynasty.
Like dynasty, dynasty Shang, Chou, Qin, Han, Sui. Yeah. Yeah. In Indonesia there is zaman Hindi, zaman penyiaran Islam and
Islam.
Kesultanan.
Yes.
And yeah. For Indonesia at the West Indonesian the timeline divide into VOC era and then Hindia Belanda era. Is that right, Pak?
Yes, like that.
Yeah. Yes. This is the time the separation of timeline in history. Everyone.
Periodisasi,
okay,
ya.
Okay, next part.
Timeline. Okay. The result of history. The result mm-hmm. history. Nah, oral history.
The sources of history.
The sources of history. Mm-hmm. Oral history. Tradisional. Cerita. History in the past. Yeah.
Story in the past.
Turun temurun. From yeah. mode to mode.
From the from our grandma to the grandchildren. Yeah.
Okay.
That is one of source of history.
Yes, oral history. We are in history called with oral history.
Oral history.
Oral history. Yes. Writing.
And then the second sources.
Second resources is writing. Yes, there is writing resources. Yeah, resources. Yeah.
Yeah.
Such as the book, chronic. Yeah, chronology.
The books.
Diary. Not to learn, maybe
notes,
yeah, file notes.
But not only in a paper, ya, Pak. Maybe not only in the paper, maybe
yes,
in
only.
The stone, maybe
yes.
at the
stone.
The stone at
in the kayu, ya,
at
apa,
the
kulit,
wood, yeah,
the wood, yeah. And the third is visual.
The third?
Resources.
Visually yeah. resources.
Yes.
Like
such
what,
as,
Pak? For
such
example.
As the prasasti, such mm-hmm. as the village, such
the palace,
as the tower.
The yeah, the tower.
The port, such as the battle.
Mm-hmm. The battle also.
The mosque. Yeah. Yeah, is yang benda, wujud benda.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That we can see and we can touch.
Yes, we can see, we can touch, yeah.
That's the
visual resources, yeah.
The visual it resource of history.
Yes. Okay. Let's review some concept. Maybe this is the meaning of history, method, object, history. First is history, auxiliary science of history, and motion of history. Okay, thanks very much.
Yeah. Thank you, Pak Incep.
Finish my presentation. Okay.
Yeah, maybe you can show the one of the previous one, Pak. Satu slide yeah. sebelum ini.
Ini?
Yeah. I will try to resume all of the material from you. In English, I will try to help
resume.
Yeah, some participant from outside of Indonesia to understand what Mr. Encep try to tell. Actually, in general, Pak Encep tell us about the story of Banten. Yeah, Pak Encep. The story
yes.
of Banten, starting from we start to understand to what is the core meaning of history itself. from Pak Encep explained before, he referred to many, many resources that history is talking about the event that happened in the past and then the growth of the human civilization, and then the history is also can be knowledge for human civilization to be learned. So in the future, we will not make the same mistake again. That's what we can learn from the history. And for the methodology in history study, Mr. Encep has explained that it has three steps of methodology in history study called for the first, let we start with heuristic. Heuristic is finding the fact related to this means to the story itself, finding the fact in from artifact and then from live witnesses, from the document, from the things that can that we can see, that we can touch. It's the method one, heuristic. And the second method is critic. After we finding the artifact or the many facts of the history, we should to criticize. Is that true? Is that is the artifact come from the resource that can be responsible, or maybe it just only artifact that made recently, that is why we need to criticize that artifact from that we get from the heuristic steps. And from the third steps called historiography. Historiography is about writing what we have found from the heuristic and criticize. It has three steps also in historiography. It's interpreting, explaining, explanation in the right or in the journal, and we should to expose. That's the method of the history study. And for the object of the history is contain the things that comes from the past. It can be form of things, document, or mosque, or building, or paper that is writing on the paper itself. That is the object of the history. And for the sources, we that the last presentation of Mr. Encep. The sources can be taken from three sources, that is oral, written, and visual resources. And when we study history, we can use the helpful tools such as archaeology, numismatic, anthropology, philology, chronology, paleology. And you should know that, like Mr. Encep explained, that the history is not run by itself. It has some motion. It has motive. It is go through by to be moved by God, by human itself, and then by the nature. That's the resume of Mr. Encep explanation about the historical knowledge. But actually, there is many story that Mr. Encep has told to us. It's about the story of Banten. Maybe Pak Hanif can help me to explain how Banten is become like now based on the story of Pak Encep. Please, Pak Hanif.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Yeah, from the 15th century, yeah?
Let me back to the Mr. Encep slide. Yeah, maybe some of you are interested in some slide, but then quite hard to understand what we are talking about. Maybe I can start from the
picture of the mosque.
Yeah, it is the Banten, old Banten Tower, and it's now studied by all of scholars from other country, from French, mm-hmm. United States, and also British. And next to the Banten Tower is the Great Mosque of Banten, Masjid Agung Banten.
The Mosque of Banten.
I think it is old picture, yeah, Bu Fatia. Now currently.
Yeah, it is old picture because today it has many renovation there.
And then Mr. Chuk also told more about the history of Banten, yeah. As we know, Banten is the west.
Yeah, the map, of, the Banten map. It's very interesting story actually.
Yeah, this is Banten's map before Dutch colonialization. Yeah, since 1569. We can see from this old maps that Banten is aquatic city at that time. So yeah. We are surrounded by a small river, at the side, and also the what we call the way of transportation in the middle, also using canals, I think, such as
the canal. Yeah, the big canal, very big canal, because the ship can be go through the canal.
And the Banten River
very big.
Is the one of the at that time the what we call the famous port at that time, yeah. And it is
the favorite port for the merchant to meet each other from around the world.
And that's why Banten become a place that our what we call colonialized Spaniards and also Portuguese camps become one of the famous spot at that time. So Banten, especially Serang at that time, is the meeting point of those two, what we call counterparts, the previous counterpart. And our history, especially Banten history, is also correlated with another country, just like Philippines and also Malaysia.
Yeah.
Since at the colonialization time, we have to at the first Portuguese and also Spanish what we call fight to beat on his area, especially for the spices. Yeah. Since they're looking for in Nusantara spices, and then at that time, at the final what we call consideration, they have to move. Yeah, at that time, Portuguese Spaniards should move to Philippines.
To Philippines.
And it's confirmed to, based on Joanna comments that Philippines. Is colonized 300 years,
by the Spain.
By the Spaniard.
Yeah.
So it's correlated to another historical moments of many areas around Indonesia, especially then. And it is the current map of Banten, and. And Jeff also talk more about the what we call the island Ujung Kulon. It's the now conservation area.
Conservation or, national conservation area.
Rhinos, rhinoceros. Yeah, what's or one what kinds of the these about changing animals now? Yeah. And yeah, I think that's, and now we have a very big chance since the colonization time, yeah, to today. So now Banten become not only aquatic movement or developmental area, but then many other economic center of the Banten are now developed due to the what we call the development of many public transportation and also satellite tolls and port and any others. From this slide, Pancep tried to inform us that at that time, Banten is one of the biggest city in the world. Yeah, compared to another big city at the past, like Paris and London. At that time, they are widely populated by more than 150,000 citizens in 1672. Yeah, I think most of Banjap slides are quite slightly understandable for Indonesia. And of course, for other participants from overseas, locally interest to some or certain slides. So after this, we have a question and answer. So maybe you have something in your mind about a certain slide. You can directly ask or confirm what this slide previously talked about. Thank you, Bu Fatih. I give it to you.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Pak Hanif. That's the story of the Banten. Okay, for the participant, maybe after this, you are all welcome to give comment, to give question maybe, or something that that come in your mind to share with us. Please, you can start. By raise your hand maybe, or give your comment and question. You can also give your comment and question in the room chat. Is there any of you who wants to share the ideas, the question, please?
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello,
Joanna.
Is Joanna?
It's actually not a question, but just some takeaways from Mr. Anchep's presentation. I just love the thing that he mentioned earlier about how history is so important in education, that it will help us, it will help the humanity, to better the humanity. And I think history is, I'm actually not a social science student, but the presentation, although there are some language barriers, but it did not hinder from me being interested on the presentation, because even though I'm not a social science student, I learned a lot about the definition of history, the methods, the motives, and I think history is a great subject to learn. For example, Mr. Enchep mentioned earlier that this can be integrated to the subjects, even though, for example, I am studying English, so in the future, I'm a language teacher. I think history is a great way to integrate on my subject, because as what Mr. Enchep mentioned earlier, it will help the humanity to better itself. And it will also help us to, like, what's the term? I forgot the term. It will help us not to do the same mistakes before. And yeah, so
Historia Magistra Vitae.
Yes,
that's Historia Magistra Vitae. Yeah.
Yes. So thank you, Mr. Enchep. I would just like to extend my gratitude for the presentation. It was a great presentation.
Okay, you're welcome, Miss Joanna, for your attention and your appreciation to my presentation. Thank you.
And Joanna, previously Mr. Ancap also talked about philology. It's also language, the correlation about how language will determine or inquire the fact from past event. And also maybe in your study, you also study about philology, how language, how a certain language acquire or find or developed. And it also correlate how the era or the terms or the situation at the past time. Can you hear my voice? Hello, Bu Fati, can you hear my voice?
Yeah. The connection is unstable here, but I can grasp what you speak and Miss Joanna mean, yeah? Yeah, I can share my opinion also that in the language knowledge, in the language study, we can use history to our student to be part of storytelling, in storytelling part in language, because sometimes when especially to the elementary school student, storytelling is the most effective way when we want to give something that they have to learn about. That's my experience, Miss Joanna. So you, the history is very helpful for the elementary student when we want to give what is that? Give the character values from the story at the past.
Actually, we have a question, Bu Fati, from Mr. Zakaria.
I didn't get the question of Miss Joanna. I'm sorry. Maybe you can help Mr. Hanif.
Yeah. The question from Mr. Zakaria. This is about Banten history. Yeah. Want to know where did Banten come from and who was built Kesultanan Banten? So, siapa yang mendirikan Kesultanan Banten? And it's Bantenese descendants, Banten Royal, still exist like Jogja. Apakah sekarang Kesultanan Banten masih eksis seperti Jogja dan Solo? Maybe this question
Jogja,
is
Cirebon.
Directly addressed to Pak Ancap.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Zakaria, yeah, for your questions. This is the, I think, the best question. Yeah. Who will the Sultan of Banten is Sultan Maulana Nasruddin, yeah, in 1556, yeah, before moving to Banten, the new Banten, yeah, but all Banten, this is the misconception, because before moving to the Raton Surosawan, the city of Banten is in Sempu, ya, in Sempu, Banten Girang. We call Banten Girang, ya. This is the near from the Seram City, maybe just 10 kilometer, ya, from the Seram City, in Banten Girang, just four years. After that, moving to the new Banten, ya. Not all Banten. And then the old Banten in Banten Girang, in now Banten Lama is new Banten. This is the misconception for the for our
the government.
Ya, for the government. Jadi Banten Lama itu Banten baru. Banten Lamanya, yeah, itu yang disebut itu, ya.
The name of Banten Lama for today.
Yeah, for today.
Actually, is new Banten, ya, Pak.
Banten. Yeah, new Banten. Karena, yeah, dia dipindahkan ibu kota baru, ya. The main city of the Banten in
Banten Girang.
Banten Girang, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now after that, he built the Surasawan village, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But the first king of Sultan is the Syarif Hidayatullah. He is the father of the Sultan Maulana Sanuddin, and the another name from Sultan Maulana Sanuddin is Pangeran Sabang Kingkir, ya. Nama lain, nama asli dari Maulana Sanuddin itu Pangeran Sabang Kingkir, ya. Nah, tapi dia lebih populer Sultan Maulana Sanuddin, ya. And then the
founding Banten father, Sultan.
Ya, yeah, the founding father is Sunan Gunung Jati. Or
Sunan Gunung Jati.
Sunan Gunung Jati.
From Cirebon, ya, Pak.
From Cirebon, yes. He is the king of Cirebon Sultanate, ya. He is married with the Bupati Banten Girang, Prabu Pucuk Umun, ya. Have the son. We are called the name. The name is apa namanya? Siapa tuh? Yang jadi gedung DPRD itu bupati apa namanya? DPRD. Jadi dia menikahi Bupati Banten, ya, Prabu Pucuk Umun. Nah, akhirnya punya anak Sultan Maulana Sanuddin. Namanya Kaunganten.
Oh, Kaunganten.
Nyai Kaunganten, ya.
Oh, Kaunganten is the name of Sultan wife.
Yes, Sultan wife. Ya, yeah, Sultan wife. Sultan Gunung Jati.
Sultan Gunung Jati. And have sons.
Pangeran Sabang Kingkir. Nah, that's called the another name is Sultan Maulana Sanuddin. Okay. He is the first king, the first sultan in Sultanate of Banten.
Mm-hmm.
After moving from the Banten Girang and build the new village called in Surasawan, yeah, Surasawan, and in 1888, ya, yeah, the Sultanate of Banten will be apa, dihapuskan itu, ya, yeah, will be
demolished.
Yeah, demolished with the Gubernur Jenderal Hindia Belanda Herman Willem Dendels. Ya, Dendels. Kenapa dihapuskan? Karena menolak, ya, untuk mengerahkan rakyat Banten membuat the post west 1000 kilometer
from
Tupanarukan.
Anyer, yeah. Tupanarukan.
Ya, yeah, Tupanarukan. Karena menolak mengerahkan rakyat itu, akhirnya 1886, ya.
Yeah, in one.
Ya, yeah, dihapuskan dan diangkat menjadi Bupati Serang Sultan-Sultan kesini setelah Sultan ke-16 kalau nggak salah, Sultan Rafiuddin itu yang terakhir, ya. Yeah.
Hmm.
Nah, jadi
The Banten Sultan is doesn't exist.
Not exist. But now there is the just the culture. There is the what is the institution? His name is Kenajiran. Do you know Kenajiran? Kenajiran is manage about the ritual such as the jarah, such as the pesantren, such as the parade budaya, culture, ritual, ya, such as panjang mulut, ya, not the government, ya, but lebih kepada budaya, ya, ritual, lebih kepada culture, yes.
To conserve the culture.
Yes. The institution is colored with Kenajiran. Ya, jadi bukan kesultanan, tapi para penerusnya, pewarisnya disebut dengan Kenajiran. Ada juga nama yang lainnya itu pemangku adat Kesultanan Banten, ya. Jadi itu bagian dari Kenajiran juga, gitu, ya. yang kemarin itu Tubagus Abbas Waseh, sekarang meninggal, diganti mungkin oleh anaknya, belum ada lagi ini, itu tadi kenajiran yang mengatur apa namanya ritual budaya, lebih kepada pemangku adat, ya, not for policy government, such as in all era, ya, in sultanat, just a ritual culture, ya, such as panjang mulut, Muharram, apa, haul sultan, ya. Jadi hanya itu saja, just ritual culture. That is my answer to Mr.
So currently the Banten Sultan didn't exist anymore since defeated by the Holland colonialization. And now currently the legacy of the Bantenists maintained by Kanaziran, ya Pak Panjab, ya Kanaziran. Especially for Kanaziran. Especially for only ritual or cultural activity, not for the government or the instrumental activity. And oh. Yeah, I think it answer Mr. Zakaria's question, yeah.
Thank you, Pak.
Thank you, Pak Zakaria.
So it also correlates to Mr. Duda.
Cirebon, yes.
Since Mr. Duda and Mr. Agnew, the founding father comes from Cirebon, ya, Pak.
Okay, because yeah, I have another agenda.
Oh yeah, yeah, okay.
Agenda. There is the Zoom meeting with the Kamit of Mokaku.
Yep. Okay, Pancep. The time is also has shown us to 3 p.m. in the afternoon. Okay, thank you for your presentation, Pancep. I hope all the participants enjoy the story of Banten from yes. Pak Encep. Before we close and say goodbye to Mr. Encep, please give him a applause.
Yes. Thank you very yeah. much.
Thank you, Pak Encep.
Vincent, maybe you can...
Yeah, we will take the photograph first, Pak Encep. Pak Hanif?
Yeah, okay. So, can... yeah. Before Mr. Encep...
Please, the participant to turn on the camera for a while.
Yeah, and we'll take documentation for today's activity. So, okay, now here we go. 1, 2, and 3.